Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, my name is Karina. Today we are getting into a thrift haul. Basically what I ended up buying while thrifting online. If you haven't seen my last video, I'm gonna put it in the card. Buying all the Pinteresty shit that I've been obsessed with. But before I get into this haul, I do wanna address some things. It's more for like me. It's just something I feel like I have to say because I feel like I just never want there to be like miscommunication or just misunderstanding as well. So basically, I filmed this video a couple days ago and today is actually like my editing day. I put the footage in my camera and I was about to just start editing the video and I realized like the whole thing was so out of focus and that there's really no way of saving the video. So instead I thought, you know what, I refilmed it. The reason why I'm telling you this is because, you know, my thumbnail looks different from what I'm actually wearing now. Did like this whole little montage in the beginning, like me unboxing everything that arrived. I was pretty bummed that it just didn't end up working out. That's my explanation. Shit happens. I'm still trying to figure out this camera, even though I've been a Sony user for a while. It's just, it's all new, baby. And it's all good. So let's get into this stuff. Sorry for the long intro. Y'all know me by now that this girl chats to the max. So now let's get into the clothes. First thing I wanted to show you that I got from ThredUp are these Roman Tenenza shoes. Look at them. They're like a polka dotty sling back square toe shoe. I was just doing a random like Google search for Roman Tenenza shoes and these popped up and I was like, oh, these are still so pretty, such like his character when he creates shoes. It's just reminding me of like a little capsule wardrobe heel because it's just a little fun character but in its neutrals. But I know with the classic white tee and jeans this would look amazing. And sorry for the use of vibe, I just, girl needs better vocabulary. Next pair of shoes are these bad boys, which is the classic half knee high chunky square toe boot. Oh girl, that was a lot in my mouth. Oh no, there's been more in my mouth. Shut up. Okay. Oh my gosh. But oh my god, I've been obsessed with the style of boot for a while. Very comfortable, very chic. Something about square toe for some reason I feel gives a more structure to the boot. I bought these so that I can replace my last square toe boots because they have been peeling everywhere. I noticed these started to peel as well. I have this thing where I love buying mostly everything secondhand, but when it comes to shoes, even thrifting them, I'm starting to feel like I buy these shoes excited to wear them, excited to get them secondhand, but a lot of the times just the quality isn't up to par. These were really affordable. These were $5 plus shipping, of course. I know I love wearing these with just like a short dress or like a mini skirt. These are just so fun. The boots that I was really excited about, let me get them for you. These are the patchwork, like knee-high boots that I was obsessed with. I saw these on Poshmark and kid you not, I just kept trying to send her offers and I just really wanted them. And then she accepted one of my offers, which is nice. And I really think these shoes are so stunning. Look at that freaking square toe. Again, the little chunky heel. These are a little bit higher. I noticed that there is like some cracking on these. They are vintage, so it does tend to happen. The way I pictured it, with a white muscle tee and jeans and wearing these, or as well as wearing it like with a white puff sleeve dress. Like that's what I imagine it, wearing these boots. Just kind of making the boots a staple. I did try these on already and unfortunately this girl got big calves. They didn't end up zipping all the way, but I love them too much, y'all, that I just can't. I'm gonna have to make it work for myself. I did do a lot of dance when I was growing up until like college. So my calves are pretty defined. Still, gonna rock them. Okay, so those are all the shoes and now we can move on to the clothes. This next piece is fun because I have an obsession with brown colored clothing, as I'm pretty sure you can tell. I feel like I want to be mixing a lot of browns with like pastel colors. When I saw this piece, I thought it was perfect because it is exactly what I wanted. It is this dress right here. Look at that. It is in this stunning like baby blue color, but then it has like that dark brown and then some kind of light brown color all over it. It's like a tie-dye style dress. I really do like it. At first, I was kind of iffy about this length because y'all know I love mini dresses, but this length was pretty nice, especially because it has like a little like cut on the side. So with some high knee boots, I think it would look really pretty. And I also got this piece on Poshmark and it was $5. Yeah, your girl tries to scour the best price that she could. I'm one of those people that I do send offers a lot of the time. Next piece, which I am really excited to show you this one because I think it's definitely one of those pieces that is identical that I thrifted from my Pinterest board. This is a piece right here. It is that faux like cardigan and it's so pretty. It also has like that ribbing material, so it has a perfect stretch. I think the one that is on my Pinterest board is like in a white color, but I was obsessed with this like taupey cream that I knew would be easy to incorporate with all of my clothing because I've also been into like creating monochromatic fits. And this is originally from Gap and it is a size extra, extra large. All right. This piece, y'all, is literally my favorite. So on eBay, I was searching for a Michael Simon cardigan or sweater. I have been obsessed with his type of cardigans. I love his work. I think it's very fun and just a little statement. And I always wanted like a funky type of cardigan from him. So I was searching on eBay and then I came across this one, which I thought it was so fitting, especially since one of the things that I've mentioned from my trends video is checkerboard and like bright colored mixing, and this literally is that piece. I found this Michael Simon cardigan, that chunky checkerboard print, but inside the checkerboards are these little flowers in different colors, all handmade. Look at this embroidery in there. With the buttons, he went white, black, white, black. It's just, those little things make such a difference. Look at that freaking tag. How sick is that? I don't know what to tell y'all. This is just one of my, honestly, one of my favorite thrifted items. I don't know what else to say. I'm just stunned by this piece. It's truly amazing and I cannot wait to rock it just like with basics, but also even with pop of colors. I think it'd be fun. This one on eBay, I believe was like $22. This might not be some of y'all's vibes, but it's definitely up mine. Like swirl marble top. But it also has sequins, so it's like the combination of both of the trends that I was talking about. I don't know if y'all see this as well as I do, but half of this long sleeve, one side is a different style of the shirt, and then this side is completely different. And then even the back is different as well. It's like this other style of print. And then over here, this like sleeve stands out by its own. I think it's just like a really fun top, a little statement for sure. I wear shit backwards all the time, but I think this style of the top will look amazing as well, like a high neck. Ooh, really, really love it. And I also love this back because I feel like there's more like that swirl, that grooviness print. I can picture this with just a skirt, maybe a chunky boot heel and a leather jacket, or maybe combining this with another print, as well as just maybe some black flare jeans, I think will look fun. I actually got this at piece on eBay. I think I paid $12 with shipping. I saw that he has multiple listings for this one, so I think he sells more of these online. So if y'all are interested, I'll leave the eBay listing down below. These next pieces are some leather jackets. I want to have a collection of leather jackets / leather blazers. It's literally the only outerwear I wear besides blazers. First one is this like tan color, almost brand new. This is by the brand called Jaw Pond Richards. It is a size 16. I got this one on Poshmark for $12 and it is pretty. I love the color. I really was contemplating between getting two different shades of brown. I can imagine me like creating like a monochromatic outfit and wearing this, or just wearing like a basic like muscle tee and jeans and this on top. So this next one is the one that I initially got first, and it is this dark chocolate brown leather blazer. I know I'm mentioning my videos again, but if you saw my last one, you saw that this is one of the first pieces that I did buy, and she gave me it at such an affordable price. I believe it was $9 with like $5 shipping. And then she did end up messaging me like I think a couple minutes later when I purchased the item. She saw that the lining ended up ripping, so I don't know right here if you can see, there's like a rip in the material, and it's also in the back here. I just noticed that too. But you know, that comes with wear and tear, and I think just getting like maybe some fabric glue would really help that out. Y'all let me know what I can do for that. Is there a specific type of glue that I need to use? This is by the brand called Mountain Lake 2, and it is a 1X. All right, y'all, we are on to the last piece. I know this haul like has been a long one. I appreciate y'all for being here. But yeah, this is basically a piece that I needed in my wardrobe to replace another one. These are just some black jeans by the brand Wild Fable. They're in the style of the High Skater Rise. I truly love this freaking style of pant. The one that I had is this exact style. It started to rip in the back area, so there was no way of fixing it, even if I added a patch. I love the high rise. I love that they're almost like wide leg, but they also end by my ankle. These are my only black jeans that I own now, and these are my favorites. The rise is amazing. Let me tell you, I can wear these with crop tops, with everything. That's why I really enjoy these. But anyways, that was everything that I ended up thrifting online. I'm so sorry that I wasn't able to include it in my last video. I truly wanted to, but I was waiting on some items, and unfortunately, the person didn't end up shipping them. I found it odd because I kept going back to seeing if she was active on the app, and she was, and I even sent her a message and she never replied. So I ended up canceling the order. I was truly waiting for that piece, and then it didn't end up showing up. So this couldn't end up being in my last video. I just want to let y'all know that that's what ended up happening. So that's why I had to split the two videos, but I'm really happy that y'all are here. Let me know what other content you'd like to see next. I'm trying to expand more. I definitely love doing those like outfit videos where I exchange in front of the camera. That one is going to be coming up soon, especially since I have new clothes as well as another closet declutter. Anyway, so that is all for today's video. Thank you so much for being here and hearing me out. It means a lot. So thank you for being here, and if you do enjoy the video, don't forget to give it a like. It lets me know what content you like to see, but as well, it helps the algorithm. So if you're new, please hit that subscribe button down below. I do a lot of just like fashion, thrifting related content, and you know, here and there I'll throw a little lifestyle video. You can follow my Instagram. It is living as Karina, and I'll see you soon, y'all. Bye. Thank you.